Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're going to look at how you can use the AI integrated into the Microsoft Edge browser to apply supervision research to your practice. This can be a really powerful feature that students and practitioners can use to save time and apply research to practice effectively. Supervision is important to any type of professional practice, because it can help you improve the service you provide. It can also improve your skills and knowledge and enable you to maintain your well-being and achieve a good work-life balance. The supervision research I'm going to use in this video is based on a social work paper. However, the lessons I demonstrate can be applied to supervision research publications in any discipline. The Microsoft Edge features I'm going to show you are currently not available on Google Chrome, which is at the moment by far the most popular browser. To download Microsoft Edge, click on the link in the description below. On this website, you can download and install Edge on just about any platform. You have Windows, Mac, your mobile devices, and you can even install on Linux. Here, I'm in Edge. And I have a website open with an article I co-wrote as part of a research team. Up in the top right-hand corner here, you'll see that there's a new icon, and this is the Bing logo. And when I click on it, this opens the Discover pane. At the top, you'll see I have access to Chat, Compose, and Insights. These are the different AI capabilities that I've got access to. We're just going to use the chat mode. Here you can see three different conversation styles. We've got creative, and this gives you an explanation of what that is, precise, and balanced. For the purposes of this video, we're just going to use balanced. In your own time, you can explore these different settings, but for now, we're just going to use balanced. So I have my research and I want to learn how I can apply the lessons from this research to my practice. So let's have a play. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to show three examples of how you can use Bing's AI on this research page. We're going to interrogate the research from the perspective of a student, a practitioner, and a supervisor. So let's begin by asking Bing the following question. I am a BA social work student about to go on my first placement. Provide me with three bullet points of the key messages from this page. Once I've typed that in, I'm going to hit the submit button. And what Bing does is it starts to search the page for information. There's a nice opening, and then it starts to pull out the key messages from the research. And what it'll do is it'll explore these from the perspective of a student. So you can see that it says that supervision is an essential element of effective professional practice in social work, especially in child protection, as it provides opportunities for reflection, support, education, and case management. And if I click this number one, you'll see that it's pulled these elements from the abstract. And then it goes on to summarize that supervision can be influenced by various factors, such as organizational design, office environments, computer systems, audit cultures, and the quality of the supervisory relationship. And that supervision can have positive or negative impacts on social workers' well-being, retention, and service delivery, depending on how it's conducted and experienced. Now, this is quite a good overview in relation to the three bullet points that are wanted as the key messages from this page. What I like is that it also gives you some suggestions for further exploration. For example, you can click on this button to say, well, what are the different types of supervision? How often should I expect to have supervision? And can you recommend any books on social work supervision? And when you do these types of research, do make sure you take a little bit of time to click these options to explore them further. But for us, let's now swap this around and assume that you're a qualified practitioner. You can ask Bing the following question. According to this research, as a qualified social worker, what steps should I take to prepare for supervision? Let's see what it says. So what it's going to do is it's going to draw on this research to answer this question. And what it says is that supervision is a vital part of professional development and practice in social work, and it provides opportunities for reflection, learning, support, and feedback. And then what it does is it provides another set of bullet points that you can explore at your own pace once it's finished generating its answer. So you can see, in response to our question about us being a practitioner and how we should prepare for supervision, it's given us a number of responses. Let's have a look at a couple of these. The first, it says, send a supervision agenda to your supervisor at least 72 hours, 3 working days before the session. In the agenda, include the topics you want to cover, such as cases, issues, challenges, achievements, learning needs, and career aspirations, and provide a brief description of each topic and attach any relevant documents or evidence. And it argues that this will help your supervisor to understand your priorities and prepare for discussion. I think these are very good points. Block off the time in your calendar and make sure that your colleagues and clients know that you're not to be disturbed during supervision. Supervision should be protected time for you to focus on your professional growth and well-being. And if possible, book a quiet, comfortable room or place where you can have privacy and confidentiality. Now, if you were to pose this question to this specific piece of research, you can take time and read some of the responses further. And what I also like is that it adds links to books that you might find of interest as well. Now, imagine that you're a supervisor. You can use Bing in the following way. You can pose the following question. I am a supervisor. What does the article say about the common pitfalls of bad supervision practice, and what can I do to avoid them? And you can see it starts to respond that based on the article we've opened, here are some common pitfalls of bad supervision practice and what you can do to avoid them. I'm just going to let it carry on generating this response. So let's have a look at what it's come up with. Remember that our original question was, I am a supervisor. What does the article say about the common pitfalls of bad supervision practice and what can I do to avoid them? Bing responds, based on the article you've opened, here are some common pitfalls of bad supervision practice and what you can do to avoid them. Let's have a look at the first one. Drawing from the research, it argues that some of the pitfalls can be that you can end up focusing too much on case management processes, such as targets and timescales, at the expense of critical reflection and emotional support. It goes on to say that this can make supervision sessions boring, tedious, and stressful for both supervisors and supervisees, and reduce the quality of service delivery. Then it tells you as a supervisor how you can avoid this. It goes on to say that you can balance the managerial and reflective functions of supervision and allocate enough time and space for exploring the complexities and emotions of the work. You can also use a more flexible and collaborative approach to setting the agenda and priorities for supervision rather than following a prescribed format or system. And then it draws on a number of things that we found in our research. And if you like, you can pause the video at any stage to read any of these further. So those are 3 really quick examples of how you can use Microsoft's Edge AI to explore research papers around supervision. Obviously, it doesn't have to be just supervision. You can use this facility to explore any research papers around any topic. You can see that using the AI integrated into the Microsoft Edge browser can be a powerful tool for not only students, but practitioners and supervisors as well, so that they can apply supervision research effectively into their practice. So by leveraging the Discover pane and the chat mode in Edge, you can extract key insights from research articles to enhance our professional skills and knowledge. You can see from the research findings that supervision is crucial for maintaining the quality of our service, improving our well-being, and achieving a healthy work-life balance. Whether you're a student, practitioner, or supervisor, AI can help you gain valuable information from research articles, making your practice more informed and effective. I hope this video will encourage you to explore the AI features in Microsoft Edge and take advantage of this exciting technology to improve your practice and continuously grow in your professional journey. The link to the research article used in this video is below. And you can also download Microsoft Edge using the link in the description as well, so that you can start applying research to your practice in a more efficient and meaningful way. I want to thank you for joining me in this video. If you found it valuable, please share your thoughts and experiences in the comments section below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more discussions on using AI technology to enhance our professional lives. As always, thank you for watching, and until next time, take care and goodbye.